There's a few cases here that are particularly interesting. This first case is a case of an awake craniotomy on a patient who was a musician. That means that the neurosurgeons removed a part of the skull under anesthesia, woke the patient up mid-surgery, and were stimulating the brain using an electrical map to see what the effects were before removing any tissue. The patient had a subsequently successful surgery and could continue playing music afterwards.
You probably have a Facebook account and an Instagram. Maybe you're on Twitter and Reddit too, or LinkedIn or something. But for most of us, social media is really basically about entertainment, surfing the web, and wasting time. But there's a Toronto startup called Figure One that's trying to use social media to revolutionize medical education.
The idea for Figure One came to me when I was doing research at Stanford in 2012. I was there studying how medical students and young physicians were using their mobile devices for medical education. We were doing a study about what they were using their devices for. What we discovered was that young physicians were using their mobile devices to talk about cases. They would text message each other, or they would email each other, and they would take pictures of what they were seeing. And those conversations would lead to learning and education. Those sorts of conversations, when I was a medical student and resident, only happened in the hallways or in meeting rooms.
We all use our smartphones for basically everything these days, and it turns out that doctors want to use their smartphones too. So it made sense to build a special social network for doctors to share their weird medical cases, with privacy and patient consent built right in. Like most sectors, healthcare is in the midst of a major technological transformation. A recent PwC survey of health CEOs found that 86% of executives expect technology to reshape their industry in the next 5 years. In the case of Figure One, Dr. Joshua Landy said there's a lot of functions for the app, but the biggest use case is education.
What Figure One does for physicians is creates a platform where it's almost like a digital teaching hospital, where you can have those hallway conversations or those meeting room type conversations and discuss a case, and you can get out of it what you want. If you're there to get help with a case, you can get it. If you're there to learn something about a case, you can. If you're there to quiz other people and sort of have a fun time with your education, you can. I mean, learning should be fun, and these conversations were the best parts of learning in medical school. So that's what we're trying to recapitulate in a dynamic environment on the phone.
About 3/4 of medical students in the United States use Figure One, and the app has users all around the world. We talked to Alicia Kaiser, who said it's a cool way to learn.
I totally geek out. Yeah, I use that for fun because it's an easy layout. It's like an Instagram for doctors. You know, you can comment on certain cases, look at cool pictures. There's an option to discuss and connect with different doctors on the app across the world, which is the nice part of it.
Alicia said the app gives her an inside track because it exposes her to more medical cases than she'd ever normally be able to see.
It's a great way to impress your attendings. Like the other day, one of my preceptors was quizzing us about a condition called normal pressure hydrocephalus. And I read a case about that on Figure One, and it was like a three-word mnemonic: wet, wacky, wobbly. And these patients tend to have bladder problems, cognitive issues, and they have an unstable gait. So, yeah, I was able to impress my attending through that.
Beyond just education, though, Dr. Landy said one of the benefits of the app is communication and the data it provides, whether it's spotting trends in the content that doctors post or allowing medical professionals to communicate and offer advice to each other.
I'm biased because the most interesting cases for me are things that used Figure One as it was meant to be used, which is stuff like a case of a young baby that was born in Haiti, and there was a nurse who was attending at the birthing station. No one else, no physicians, and she was there alone. This baby was born with an unusual skin condition that looked scary. And the nurse posted the case to Figure One. 16,000 people lent their opinion, and the answer came back that the baby is going to be fine. This was just a temporary rash that would fade on its own. But that answer came from the other side of North America on the West Coast, when this nurse who had literally nothing in their healthcare system was able to access the knowledge of people and get that information when she needed it.
Over the past few years, Toronto has emerged as a significant tech hub, with nearly $3 billion US dollars in venture capital deals for startups between 2015 and 2017. This year, at least $259 million US dollars have been invested in health startups here. But many entrepreneurs say funding can still be hard to come by. I asked Dr. Landy, what are the benefits of starting a medical tech startup here in Canada?
I think that Canada is a great place to do what we're doing. I think especially because the Canadian values of universal healthcare sort of infuse the idea of creating healthcare where the knowledge is available to anyone in the world at any time. That said, I think that there are unique challenges to starting a company in Canada, and you have to be creative. But that's not unusual. There's unique challenges to building a company in every country.
One of the interesting things about Figure One is that it turns a regular smartphone into a medical tool for doctors. And we've actually been seeing a fair bit of this sort of thing recently, blurring the line between medical technology and regular consumer devices. The new Apple Watch, for example, has an electrocardiogram built right into it, and tens of millions of people wear Fitbits that track basic health metrics. Dr. Landy said that Figure One is taking it one step at a time, but they plan to expand the service, and maybe one day it could be a portal to access medical expertise right through your smartphone.
The first 5 years of Figure One were used to build a network of healthcare professionals who can teach and learn from each other. The next 5 years is going to be built expanding that network and creating more and more utility for those physicians. 5 years after that, who knows, it could be patients can be welcome in the world's digital teaching hospital. But I think we'll take it 1 year at a time for now.